Do you realize what he's saying? In those days, the way you took an oath was not by signing. How wimpy. What would that mean? Here's what you would do. Is you would take an animal, you would slay it, you would cut it, put it down on the ground, and you would walk between the pieces, and this is what you were saying. You're saying, if I do not do everything that I am promising now, may I be cut off. May I be destroyed. May my flesh lay on the ground to feed the birds of the air and the beasts of the field. That's what you're doing. A fairly effective way, don't you think? A lot better than signing, huh? You see, vivid. But when you did it, you were bound. You acted out the curse. Now, when Abraham was told, bring me all these pieces, he immediately knew what was going on. This was a covenant ratification ceremony. This was the making of a contract. He knew right away, and he figured. What did he figure? Well, he didn't figure what actually happened. No one on the face of the earth figured what actually happened. Here's what happened. First, when the sun had set and darkness had fallen, a smoking pot and a blazing torch appeared. And it's the same words used to describe the top of Mount Sinai when God came down on it years later. And the same words that were also used to describe the pillar of God's presence. It was the presence of God. But it wasn't just the presence of God that astonished Abram, but what it did. Look, verse 17. It passed between the pieces. It went down the aisle made by the pieces. And here's the reason this was so strange. This is so incredible. This is the gospel. This is the whole gospel. There is no place in the New Testament that gets as thoroughgoing as this. And it's absolutely astonishing that what God does is he appears and he passes between these pieces. Do you now know what he's saying? Do you know what he's saying to Abraham? Do you know what he's saying to you? He is saying, I have promised to bless you, Abraham. I have promised to be your God and to bring salvation to the world. I have promised to bless you. And if I don't do what I say, may my immutability experience mutation. May my immortality suffer mortality. May my infinity suffer limitation and finitude. May my power suffer powerlessness. May the impossible become possible. May I be cut off. May I be destroyed. May my body be ripped to pieces. God saying this. Now, if you think that's amazing, it is, but that's not all. God walked through the pieces alone. He did not say, Abraham, now you do it. And let me tell you, this is absolutely, absolutely unique and stunning, because we know this from history and archaeology, that whenever a king would enter into a covenant relationship with a vassal, a lesser king, or a conquered king, or a servant. Whenever a king would enter into a covenant relationship with a servant, either both the king and the servant would go through the pieces, or just the servant would go through. But when the king goes through by himself, this is what God is saying. God is saying, Abraham, I'm going to go through for both of us. This is the gospel. The gospel that salvation in the Christian faith is not a cooperative effort. It is not God helps those who help themselves. It is not a partnership. God comes through and says, I will take upon myself the curse of the covenant for both of us. Abraham, may I be cut off if I don't do my part of the bargain, but Abraham, may I be cut off if you don't do yours. Abraham, I will bless you, even if it means, and it did, that I would have to die. Don't you realize that centuries later, darkness came down again? You read about it in Mark chapter 15, verse 33, where it says, and at the sixth hour, darkness came over the whole land. And the ninth hour, Jesus cried, my God, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Isaiah 53 verse 8 says something that Abraham didn't know. Abraham had no idea what it was going to cost God to make the promise he did. But Isaiah says about the Messiah, he was cut off from the land of the living. For the transgression of my people, he was stricken. His immortality did become mortality. His immutability did suffer mutation. The impossible became possible. God was cut off. God was trampled into the dust. The darkness came down on him.